Good day. Dogs, plastic sculptures, and organizers, glass bottles for the articles, decanter, storage item, perenniums, cut bottles, bent bottles, and glass tiles, fabric scrap for the articles, quilting and patchwork projects, rugs, dollies, runners of hands, chests, circles of fabrics, stock toys, hair accessories, fabric flowers, and collages. Yarn waste. For the articles, we have rugs, tape strays, embroidery, yarn dolls, crocheted or knitted articles, and string arts. Tin cans. For the articles, we have canisters, storage bins, planters, baking tins, candle holders, kerosene lamps, metal arc, and water cutters. Origami is a Japanese term from ori means folding, and kami meaning paper. Kami changes to gami due to rentaku. It's the art of paper folding, which is often linked with Japanese culture. History of origami. Origami of classic and traditional origin. Paper was first invented around 105 AD in China, and in the 6th century was brought to Japan by monks. Handmade paper was a luxury object for a few, and paper folding in ancient Japan was primarily for ceremonial purposes, mostly religious in nature. By the Edo period, 1603 to 1868, paper folding had become both recreational and ceremonial in Japan, sometimes featuring numerous cuts and folds. It came to be recognized as a modern art form allowed by the invention of paper, both mass produced and more affordable. Written instructions for paper folding first appeared in 1797 with Simbazuru Furikata by Akisato Rito for 1,000 grain folding. In Europe and in Japan, by the 1800s, kindergarten-aged children were studying paper folding. History of origami, modern origami. Akira Yoshizawa, who died at the age of 94, 2005, is believed to be one of the progenitors of modern origami. In the 1930s, using a series of symbols, arrows, and diagrams, he developed a method of folding patterns. Those patterns were published and widely available by the 1950s, leading to the global scope and standardization of origami. Yoshizawa and other masters of origami founded local and international organizations which promoted the craft. Today, as seen in Between the Folds, origami has expanded to include advanced mathematical theories. Prior to folding, mathematical origami pioneers such as Jun Meikawa and Peter Engel modeled complex and mathematically based crisp patterns that stress the puzzle aspect of origami using the criteria of one piece of uncut paper. Paper weaving is an art wherein thin strips or sheets of paper are glued together to make new designs that are durable and colorful. Here are the tools and materials in basket making. Old newspapers, magazines, and papers. It is used as base of origami basket. Scissors, used to cut papers to rectangular strips in basket making. Stapler, used to hold paper in place. Glue or paste, used to hold paper together. Ribbons, adds beauty to origami basket. Accessories, it may be added for decoration purposes like cloth, buttons, etc. Procedures in making recycled origami basket. Number 1. Remove the fold from the section of your paper to each of the 12 inches by 22 inches of each page. Number 2. Fold each page along its length in half, then into 8. The resulting rectangular strips should be about 1 to 1.5 inches by 22 inches. You're going to need a lot of them. Number 3. Start by weaving in the centers of 4 strips. A single staple or a glue dot can be replaced at each overlap to hold it in place if necessary. Number 4. Continue to weave strips to your choosing dimension. Example, 10 strips by 8 strips or the overall 15 inches by 12 inches. Number 5. Simple fold all strips up to 90 degrees for the side of the basket and continue weaving. Make sure your strip remain tightly woven. In doing so, be patient. Number 6, bend your side strips at the corners and continue to weave along the adjacent edges. Glue or staples are especially recommended for holding things in place. Number 7, add a double folded strip along the top edge. This could add force to the top rim. Glue over the inside of the basket. Number 8, add a ribbon to the basket for decoration along the four sides. How to make recycled pillow. Steps in pillow making. Number 1, collect the materials needed in pillow making. Number 2, cut the plastic foil into strips about an inch long. Cut the strips thinly until you have enough plastic foil packs to fill your pillow. Number 3, sew the cloth or plastic cover edges and leave a small opening. Number 4, fill the pillowcase with a thinly cut plastic foils. Number 5, close the opening to ensure that no filling will come out. Trivia. According to sleepfoundation.org, many doctors recommend replacing pillows every 2 years. This may not seem like much, but pillows go through wear and tear quite a bit. They can accumulate quite a few unpleasant things like saliva, skin oils, makeup, dead skin cells, and even dust mites and mold. Clothing recycling is part of the recycling textiles. It involves the recovery of old clothes for sorting and processing. End products include clothing suitable for reuse, scraps of cloth or rugs, as well as fibrous materials. The interest in the recycling of clothing is rising rapidly due to environmental awareness and pressure on landfills, and it provides a business opportunity for entrepreneurs. Tools and materials in pillowcase making. Old polo. It is used as main material in pillowcase making. Scissors. It is used to cut cloth for making pillowcase. Tape measure. It is used for measuring more than 1 foot distance. Thread. It is used for sewing and hold cloth together. Ruler. It is used for measuring cloth and making straight lines. Needle. It is used for most standard embroidery stitches. Pencil. It is used for marking drawing lines. Ribbon adds beauty to pillowcase. Accessories may be added for decoration purposes. How to make recycled pillowcase. Procedure. Number 1. Measure the length and width of the pillow you want to make a case. Number 2. Transfer the measurement to the pillow using pencil and ruler. Make sure the pillow is turned to wrong side. Number 3. Cut the pillow with 1/2 seams allowance from the mark. Number 4. Stitch along the raw edges of the pillow using running stitch. Number 5. Turn the pillowcase right side out. Gently poke the corners. Number 6. Fill the pillowcase with pillow and bottoms up the case. Always remember the saying that there is money in waste. All we need is a little entrepreneurial ability and a lot of environmental concern. Instead of throwing our waste and scrap into our home and absolutely wasting it, we should build and recycle it into useful, artistic fragments for personal and home use. Recycling helps protect the environment, saves money, and reduces emission of greenhouse gases, which help mitigate climate change. Thank you for watching and see you in our next video lesson.
Kung ikaw ay bago at nagustuhan mo ang aking video, unang padaan na lang, maaari mong i-click ang subscribe button at ang notification bell para ma-update ka sa aking channel. Thank you for watching!